Hello and good day, everybody. We're here on Lincoln Creek, FS15, by Rana Sparks. Doing some corn harvest today. We're just heading out with the farm truck, fuel tank, top up one of the combines a little bit, getting a little low on fuel, not sure. So might as well fill them up before we get going again. Recorded this video earlier, but I goofed it up, so there was absolutely no sound, so we're going to try it again. And so, hopefully I'm doing it right this time. Otherwise, that'll be unfortunate. We're running some fairly decent equipment. It's definitely a chore to keep up with. The grain cart and semi, trying to keep up with these two combines out here. Alright, well, it's a little more fuel anyway. So yeah, we're using Western Star 4900 for a Wilson trailer for hauling grain. Also, this old International cab over grain truck occasionally takes a load off the field. We also have Versatile 360 out here working some soybean stubble with the Landall. So it's AI will be taking care of that. We'll occasionally need to check in on them during the video. We got a shitful equipment here. I'll move the farm truck off the field so we don't accidentally run it over. That should be a safe spot. Alright, here's a green cart. So yeah, today we got Legendary Limited Edition Versatile 550 on a Brent grain cart. It's fairly nice size for this sort of operation, a little bigger than the semi-trailer. So we can always try to make sure that the semi is leaving the field at 100%, even if the cart isn't at 100%. We'll unload the combines here, and once we get that done, we'll go through them. Most of the mods used today are private. If you haven't seen a link for it somewhere, it probably is private. That's safe assumption I'll give you, because any of the ones that are, a lot of it's either in-game, or if they are public, they are on pretty much any mod site on the internet. So if you can't find it, you probably need a lesson on how to learn, on how to use Google there. And so yeah, the interior on this tractor we haven't gotten to overhauling yet. Hopefully I'll be doing it up soon to match the 360 mechanical front models quality wise. This is just a polygonish model, just a not very high quality bake on it, and that's all that was done to it. So going through and adding in all the working dash and the light up buttons and everything on it. I'm using the manual transmission mod today, one of my favorites from back in 15, and it's glad it's made it to 17 as well. Using it in automatic today just for simplification, but occasionally I will run it full manual with throttle control and everything to set up a realistic experience. Today I just decided to go simple since I'm recording and men aren't that great at multitasking. So we'll go take a look. We got a versatile RT490 here with the in-game Capello Cornhead 12 row. It's just a reduckle of the in-game combine now, but hoping to, in the near future, take it back to Blender and build it as a Canadian-built by versatile combine instead of a Rosslyn Ash-built model, which is a few subtle little changes, and also deckle it up into both paint schemes, it appears, in real life. And we have Lexion 740 here by TexFlick. It's got a newer version in the works, which should fix everything up that it has for issues right now. But it looks pretty good. We also run a Capello 12 row on it, since it's a 740 model. Yeah, we already gone through the trucks. Low on fuel too. Yeah, hopefully doing the four-wheel drive up to interior of similar standard as this one. Maybe reuse some parts from this one just for simplicity. And in the shed here we've got 550 2016 or earlier model with loaded with rear weights here for heavy tillage, high traction situations, Meridian tender, DB60 or planting equipment, as well as this versatile 360 with the row crop setup, and a Montag for additional fertilizer capacity there. Now we got a helper that thinks he's done. And we're also just using the in-game U-Haul and sprayer since I don't have one yet that tickles my fancy, but hopefully in the future I will be building my own. I think he's done. Yeah. We'll switch him over to this side here. We are missing a little bit of corn, but yielding so well, I don't think it really matters too much. A little bit we're missing. Let's see, and I'll finish this little shrimps. And back to the cart. We'll have to head to the far end of the field here to find a little bit versatile. Farm truck that I made at the start of the video there, we'll hopefully be uploading it to Giant's Mod Hub next week, and hopefully they'll approve it so that you guys can have a old school farm truck. See, we'll maybe do a little bit more work on it to make it look a little more used and abused, like many farm trucks are. So hopefully the RT490 can make it down to the end here. I'm really enjoying Lincoln Creek. It's definitely my favorite project from Random Sparks that I've used. Just the environment of the map, the crop textures and everything just looks so good. Especially, don't have it now, but the wheat stubble and chop straw combination just look really good. Fortunately, I don't have any wheat harvested this time around. And there goes the 360. A little gloomy out today, but that's okay. Corn isn't wet or anything, so we're fine. We're only farming fields 44 and 45 on here, since just playing on single player, don't want to go too hardcore and spend, you know, a full week just harvesting or a full week planting. So we'll just doing these two fields, so it's solid. Solid 2 days, a few hours each day. Harvest ain't too bad. Nice break from some modding projects. Can't talk there. Nice to just come in and sit here and drive a grain cart. Making pretty good time, I'd say, through the field. We're about an hour in or so, hopefully. Only an hour left. Autosave lagging things up. But crashed the game enough times that that little bit of lag is worth it. Alright, got enough here to top up the semi. I just don't think it has anything in it yet today, but for those of you wondering, I believe this field is around 75 acres in total. It's quite the project, definitely, to harvest it. That's for sure. And planting, both fields I planted, actually, no hired worker. It was all GPS and sometimes markers too, depending on what part of the field. To finish now. Gotta load the semi up nice and good. It's the beauty of dynamic field planes. Right. Now we're using the neighbor's farmyard, fortunately. He doesn't mind that we're trampling all over the place, but I'm sure he'd do the same if he owned a field next to our farmyard, so. Kirby pattern there is courtesy of Follow Me. Quite fancy, that's for sure. Alright. Load of corn. I think I will haul to the elevator again. It's almost closer than going home. I think the price was too bad last time we played, so. Thinking about switching combines, so might as well sell some corn and hopefully we'll be able to afford. A little hot there. Hopefully we'll be able to afford, I think, a pair of New Hollands just because tank capacity. Make the switch. I don't know of any versatiles with hopper extensions, so I can't really come up with one, although I might homemade or build a homemade one just to keep the one brand going. Wouldn't have chose the close, but or the close, but figured I better use it since Tech sent it to me. The hired worker turned around here. Last pass up the field. Useful, versatile. $32,000 for a truckload of corn, not too bad. Don't mind that, that's for sure. Only it'll take another 10 truckloads at least to pay the difference between the used combines and the new ones. Oh, Lexion's almost full too. Getting behind almost here. Oh, first test full again. Have to make a few fuel runs here too, looks like. Yep. Maybe we'll have to spend some of that money on a Thunder Creek trailer. I think it might be worth it. With the amount of fuel being burned right now. Really hope to buy a wheel soon because finger tapping works on the keyboard, but it's not the highest quality, that's for sure. Oh, look at it, came on. Head on. He's gonna be full. Got some sound work to do on this unit yet. And got a new set of wheels I need to texture up. put on it, replace the heavy-duty style sort of with just a traditional Alcoa. Trailer project as well soon. Maybe I should have switched to a Trinity brand belt trailer for this, but maybe I will yet. The extra capacity would be nice to have for corn. Shortly, and that'll give another trailer option. Well, we don't need to start the corn yet, but fix up the implement cam on the land, I'll hear it. It doesn't really work at all when you're in the ground. I do like the gentle hills in Lincoln Creek. It's not perfectly flat, but it's not so steep that you need an excessive tractor just for your implements, which is nice. But it also makes for some nice pictures. Here. First off, I'm showing the long passes. I think he's done with the neighbor's field. Probably should have done a border pass. But it's a little pretty busy right now for that, but I guess we'll do it anyway. Because this is going to take just much time to hop back and forth. All flashing hubs, that's new. Looks like a recall. Didn't do that the other day. That's what I love about Farm Sim. Your mods just break for no reason sometimes. It's pretty fun. Oh. Split second off there. That's just delightful. I really enjoy it when it breaks things for no reason. Occasionally, but it does have the tilting axle, which is the tilt to it, which is quite nice. Keeping the wheels on the ground on straight lines. Here now. Closing out a half hour here, don't mind the first video too long and have you fall asleep. So I think we'll haul this trailer load of corn to town, and I think we'll call it a day here. Into town, but so it's the decision-making process of which one to take. So each one does have an advantage and a disadvantage to it. But I think most of them, it's mostly that they're both just tight in general. tricky approach angle onto the scale, but it works. Well, with that, I think we'll call it a day. So, have a good day, and happy farming.